Right, this is Noel, Missouri. And I have to go out. This is going to be fun. I got to go out Highway 90 because I got to go south. So let's see if I can. So they don't. So this is Tyson at Noel, Missouri. They're short staffed. They don't have enough security anymore because getting the death jab was part of the mandate for people. So a lot of people left because they don't want to get the death jab. So of course, when you're used to something all the time, and you come here and you're used to how operations work, you never expect it to change. But when it does change, it throws you because you're used to their system. So this morning I come in at like 2:15, 2:20, and I drop the trailer. And Mr. Happy, the security guard, he's never happy. He's just assertive. You just do what he tells you to do, and you're good to go. So, I'm like 72,000 pounds, so I've got to get to that bit in a minute. I'm jumping ahead. So I dropped the trailer this morning, tell him I'm out of time, because he tells me my load's ready. But I tell him I'm out of time, so I'm going to, park that, take my break, and then I'll leave after my break. So normally there's security here all the time. Of course, I go to. Oh, there is a. I should have gone shopping. Yeah. They do have a store in there. I should have gone shopping. Never mind. I just forgot they had a Hometown Fresh here. I should have gone shopping. But never mind. It is what it is. About it too much. Well, there's a Dollar General here, and there's a Harps down the road there. That van coming round here. Look at him. Look at him. I'm real, man. He's 35, mate, not fucking 105. I dropped the trailer and then parked up. Then I goes to go to get my trailer and security's not there. That's really weird. And I went, okay, it's freaking me out. Things like that do freak me out. So then I call them and then I get a hold of the geezer over there and he tells me what trailer to pick up. So I goes over to them and then I'm like, I want an actual way out. Well, my CB's wanked, so I've got to get a new CB eventually when I feel like it. Not that I ever really need it. So my CB's messing me around.
Your seatbelt is
So then I go over and I can't actual way. He says, no, you just got a gross way. I'm like, well, that's really weird. And he goes, I'll explain it to you in a minute. And I'm like, okay, that's really weird.
Your seatbelt is unbuckled.
this is going to be fun. 90's awesome. It's all right during the night time because you can see if anyone's coming. During the daytime, it's going to suck. So anyway, I scale out and then I come back round like normal, park out, walk in, and I find out he's shipping, see, he's not security. So I'm all like, I'm not, see, they think I'm mad and I'm not, I'm frustrated because it messes with my head, see, and they're like, you say I'm not frustrated, I'm not mad, I'm frustrated because I know how the system works and I'm used to it. You know, I've been coming here now for a period of time, I'm used to your system. And he goes, I'm shipping, not security. That's why they won't let me actually weigh you out. They gave me like an hour's training on what to do, and then, you know, and I'm like, oh, okay, all right. So, well, I'm sorry if I came across like that, because that wasn't my intention. You know, I didn't mean to be an ass. Well, he was really cool. We ended up talking, and he said that they can't hold anybody. Hell, no one's coming down the hill. I have to get over enough, else I'll drop the trailer down the cockpit. That's my oil pressure. I've got to stop getting oil change done. Telling me I got low oil pressure. been there 23 years, that geezer I was talking to. 23 years, man. And he said four other plants are struggling to get anybody to work, basically. I said, I know, man. I see it out there all the time, like, you know.
Excellent rally track.
happens in the... Oh, here we go. I just want to get there and park up. That's all I want to do. Yeah. I see it keeps bringing it into picture. It really sucks, doesn't it? I think, does it... I don't know. Does it... No, no, it doesn't spoil it. How can it spoil it?
Your seatbelt.
There we go. I moved it a little bit. Will it make a difference? Probably not.
Your seatbelt is on.
past her, in her Mercedes look. And she didn't like that, so now she passed me back.